APFA's program by and about people with disabilities. We air the first, third, and fifth Fridays of the month, alternating with Education Today. I'm Adrienne Lobby, and here I'm with the full crew of Pushing Limits, Josh Elwood, Shelley Berman, and Sheila Gunn Cushman. And today we'll be talking with Becky and Dena Taylor, the co-authors of Tell Me the Number Before Infinity. We'll also be playing Every Crumb, Every Minute, Every Day, a song John McCutcheon wrote after he read Dena and Becky Taylor's book. And yeah, we'll be offering copies of their book to thank people for becoming members of KPFA. But before we begin with that, I would like to take a minute to speak to those affected by the flooding around the state. Well, it's a climate crisis, and I know, we know that many of our listeners are suffering. If you haven't done it already, it's a good time to check in with your neighbors. You know, I don't have to tell you folks what you already know, that this radio is a lifeline. And I thought Shelley was going to talk about this a little bit more, but maybe she's...
There I go. Thanks.
Great.
Well, we're live radio, folks. So,
just in case you didn't know.
Yeah, I'm Shelley. And I don't have to tell you folks what you already know, that radio is a lifeline. That radio doesn't depend on an app or a computer or electricity. Radio operated by batteries, just like a landline on your telephone, require nothing but turning on.
Or even a crank.
And, well, we're not cranky right now.
No, the cranking radios.
And when you are in the flood zone, stuck in your house, and the electricity and heat are off, you have KPFA to keep you company. 50,000 watts of community radio streaming in, reminding you, you are not alone. I just want to honor this institution in its 70th year, speaking truth to power. And who powers us? You do. By supporting this radio station, its 50,000 watts will be there the next time you find yourself on an island. And there will be a next time. Dial 1-800-439-5732. Support Pushing Limits, the show that beams the voices of disability community into your lives.
You can also go to www.kpfa.org if you'd like to do it online securely and quickly.
And speaking of voices of the disability community, we lost Carrie Ann Lucas. She was a prominent disability rights activist and attorney who died this past Sunday after being refused an essential medication by her insurance company. Lucas, who had a rare form of muscular dystrophy, helped pass legislation in Colorado to protect parents with disabilities from child welfare discrimination. And in 2017, Lucas was arrested with several others after protesting Medicaid budget cuts with a 58-hour sit-in at Senator Cory Gardner's office. According to the message on Lucas's Facebook page, United Healthcare denied her coverage for an antibiotic last year, triggering a host of medical complications that led to her death. Carrie Ann Lucas was 47 years old and is survived by her four adopted children, all of whom also live with disabilities. Our sincere condolences go out to her friends and comrades. She will be greatly missed. And now, we turn to the story of a girl with a quirky mind, an eccentric family, and, oh yes, a disability. Welcome, Becky Taylor.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you for having me on the show.
And welcome to your mother, Dena Taylor.
Oh, thank you.
So I think, Dena, I want you to just start talking about the title of this book, which is Tell Me the Number Before Infinity.
Okay. Well, it was Hanukkah, and Becky's dad and I were going to make our own candles for the menorah. Becky was 4 years old, and she said to us, while we were trying to figure out how many we need, you know, it's rather complicated, and she said, you need 44 altogether. And that shocked us, and so we just bent down to her and said, how do you know that? And she said, one day I was just lying in bed and I figured out how to do that sort of problem. So After that, the whole family, I mean, my parents and everybody, was asking her to multiply 2 3-digit numbers and in her head, and she did it. And her dad was asking her lots of questions all the time. And so one day he said, okay, smarty pants, if you know everything, remember, she's 4 years old, is infinity an odd or an even number? So she paused for a minute and smiled broadly and said, tell me the number before infinity.
And of course, he just pulled that one right out, I'm sure.
I'm so jealous.
So this book is told in alternating voices. Your mother, the daughter, as a team, you talk about the obstacles and harassment Becky faced, particularly as a person with a visible disability, which was cerebral palsy. All the bullying, the teachers with inflexible rules, the lack of support, even from some disability center staff. It's very frank, and it's very intimate, probably because of your relationship. But I think that it's a story that's not told enough, that we think we won. You know, we got people with disabilities into mainstream education. But you were kind of a pioneer in that, Becky. Is that true?
Yeah, I was.
And what time was this? Like the 70s, 80s, what?
This was 1975.
Yeah.
When the federal law was passed.
Yeah. About the same time I was in school.
Mm-hmm. And Becky was 3 and was going to what they called a school for handicapped children at the time. And people that ran the federal Head Start program came in looking for someone to be in their Head Start program, since they were supposed to be integrated now. And they picked Becky. So from age 3, she was mainstreamed.
So you were one of the first tokens, Becky.
Yeah, I was.
And then went from there all the way through college.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it didn't get any easier because all the way through I would be up against resistance from teachers or school administrators who didn't have any experience in dealing with how to treat a person.
So you were like teaching them how to teach you.
And you're 3 years old, and how does a 3-year-old know how to teach anybody anything? I mean, I didn't.
Thank goodness you were a genius.
Yeah, right.
Well, that's where my parents came in.
Yeah.
Well, that's right. And that's where so many parents help us get through especially those first years. I wondered if you'd share the poem with you that you wrote called Some People. I think this encapsulates a lot of your experience in all kinds of schools.
Yeah. I scare some people with my presence. Not many know how to react when they see me. There are strangers who use simple words when talking to me. Some raise the pitch of their voice. Others increase the volume. People I've never seen before come up to tell me how lucky I am, how brave. People expect many things from me. Some want me to teach them. Some expect me to be stupid. Others want me to solve the world's problems. Many are amazed that I'm just living my life.
Yeah.
Many don't listen to what I'm saying. Many don't want to let go of their ideas. However, some have.
However, some have. And thank goodness for that.
Yeah.
So now you're a computer science... Help me with this. I know you did something in STEM, and you are in UC Santa Cruz. Where are you at now? What are you doing now?
Right now, I'm doing computer tutoring, and I'm active on all sorts of commissions and boards.
Vice chair of the Santa Cruz Commission with Disabilities? I did that wrong. They did the name of it wrong.
Well, actually, I went from vice chair to chair to just to just another member, and also I'm pretty active in Santa Cruz transportation issues. Uh-huh.
So you kind of got the booby prize. You know, you were headed off to this grand career through college, and you got to be an activist instead.
Plus, she's a website designer. She's leaving that out.
Yeah, I am. And I designed the website for this book, Tell Me the Number Before Infinity.com, where you can get some more information about this book. And also, if you pledge, then of course you can get your own copy.
Which reminds me, we are actually in a fund drive. If you want to become a member of KPFA's listenership that provides the lights to stay on, the transmitter to keep going, and us to be able to be here and tell these stories, you might want to call 800-439-5732, which is Hey KPFA, or go to www.kpfa.org, and you can do things online there. And we have a match from, do I get to say who it is or no?
You sure.
I realized I should check before I just started rolling it. Albuquerque, New Mexico.
Yep, we do.
Woman by the name of Rain.
A man by the name of Rain.
Whoops.
$500 match. So now's the time to call and double your money. 1-800-439-5732 if you want a copy of Tell Me the Number Before Infinity.
Whose website is very accessible, by the way.
By the way, please dial that number and join in at $75 and get yourself a copy of the book. And we just did get a call from Cynthia in Santa Rosa, and her comment is, thank you, Adrian, you rock.
All right.
So there. Yeah. You rock,
Adrian. I always wanted to be a piece of granite. That's good.
Well, you'll survive the floods in that case. So please join Cynthia and call us at 1-800-439-5732 and get your very own copy of Tell Me the Number Before Infinity for a $75 pledge.
You know, this is an amazing book, really. It is so rare to have two people, and I think we all know how important parents are in the educational process, especially in the lower grades. To have both you and your mom, Becky, here to give us the different experiences you have. It's not always the same. And yet you tell it so factually, so sort of bluntly. Oh, this thing happened. Yeah, this teacher was, he wouldn't let me have extra time on the test, even though it's against the law for him to say no. And you both have your experiences with that. And I think anyone who has a disabled kid, who is thinking about raising a disabled kid, or just is part of the educational system. Maybe those are the people who should most get this book.
And you're right, Adrian, that our perspectives can be completely different. I mean, sometimes Becky would email me something and I think, I remember other things about that, or I saw it differently. So in this book, you know, you'll have the same incident told from our two perspectives. And of course, we didn't change each other's. I mean, you know, everybody's perspective is definitely valid. But it was just interesting to have the two different points of view.
Well, I really admire that you didn't try to smooth it over.
No.
You know, you didn't try to make it all perfect and sweet and, oh, look at how wonderful things are. Because, you know, it doesn't always get better. And yet, the more we look at things in reality, what they really are, the more chance we have of making things better, for at least for the next generation.
Becky, I'm curious. I was mainstreamed, too, and I was mainstreamed in the Bay Area. And my mom was fairly supportive, and she went to the IEPs and she fought for my stuff. But there seems to, since you've been mainstreamed, what are the good and what are the bad of mainstreaming?
Well, the good is that you can feel like you're doing something good for the people who come after you.
Yeah.
Oh, so that the next person, the next time this person encounters someone with a disability, they'll know how to react, and also for me, I felt like the people who I would have to encounter in my life are oftentimes going to be people like these people who I'm encountering right now. And so I better learn how to deal with them as best as I can.
So that was the voice of Becky Taylor, who is here with her mom, Dena. And they are the co-authors of the book, Tell Me the Number Before Infinity. You're listening to Pushing Limits on KPFA. And today we're in pledge drive mode and offering this particularly wonderful book for a $75 pledge.
Yeah, and join Jean from Elsa Bronte, who just pledged at $75. And she says that, Becky and Dena, you are fabulous. Lots of love. Join Jean. We have no callers on the line. We have a $500 matching grant right now. Your dollars will be doubled by rain in Albuquerque, New Mexico. Give us a call, 1-800-439-5732, and get yourself a copy of this book, or go online at kpfa.org and peruse all the gifts you can get. There is a great deal of things you can get, but the point is to support disability voices, disabled voices right here on KPFA. We need you to let us know that we matter to you. The reason we're on the air is because our community rises up when we ask and supports us at whatever dollar amount that you can afford. If it's $75, fabulous. You can get yourself a book. $25 makes you a voting member of KPFA. Join us at 1-800-439-5732 at whatever amount you can afford to keep voices of disabled folks on the air right here with 50,000 strong watts.
Absolutely. So thank you, Jean. That's great. And I listen to KPFA quite a bit, even though I live, 75 miles away in Santa Cruz.
Well, we've got a translator there, so you probably get a good signal, no?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And it's just wonderful that we've got this batch because we have a $2,000 goal for this Whoa. Hour. So we really need to step wow. up, get the $500 matching numbers. And I want to appeal to you. If you have ever been educated by someone like Becky, and I know I have, that give us back a little bit. Because I think on this program, we educate people every week we're on the air. We bring in people with disabilities with a whole variety of skills and limitations. And I know we educate you. I know I educate myself every time I do a program. So if this has been you, come on, step up, give us a little money, become a member of KPFA and support us at 1-800-439-5732.
Becky, have you gotten any feedback about, I mean, I didn't. When I was 7 years old, I felt like I was not accepted. And I felt like, in reality, I might be accepted to a greater or lesser degree, but I would never really be accepted. And I learned that at that young age, and I think that you experienced a lot of the same sort of stuff. But do you feel, do you know whether kids are getting a better, like, are the yard duty people actually knocking off the bullying that happens and trying to open things rather than close things and stuff, or do you know, or what?
I don't feel that there are, but I do feel that I do feel the issues are changing.
Oh, in what way?
For example, there's a parent in Santa Cruz who is getting an all-inclusive playground built in the county. So
cool.
So that her three kids could go and play together, and also there's another group of parents in Santa Cruz who are concerned about what's going to happen to their children with various disabilities as the day the parents age.
Right.
And so they are building a farm and community for their kids.
Wow. Well, I appreciate that those things are happening, but not every kid gets to have a song written about them by John McCutcheon. So I wonder, Dena, if you would read the poem that you wrote that inspired the song.
Oh, I don't think this poem inspired it.
Well, in any case.
Okay. I think it's what inspired it is when John McCutcheon actually emailed us and he said when he read that Becky said, we should enjoy every crumb of every minute of every day. that he said, that's got to be in the song. But this poem that I wrote is, and she said that when she was a young kid. This is when she was older, and it's the poem's called Finding Crumbs. When you were seven and said we should enjoy every crumb of every minute of every day, you didn't know there would be minutes, days, too terrible to enjoy, too dark to find even crumbs. But still, somehow, that young spirit endures.
Let's hear the song.
Cerebral palsy, they've said, it's in a song. Right there on the table, didn't take too long. Worry about the way I walk, or fret about the way I talk. Not here, 'cause I learned how to be strong. Every crumb, every minute, every day. Every precious second, every word we choose to say. I'm gonna live out loud and stand proud until I'm called away. Every crumb, every minute, every day. Oh, I've seen the way that some will mask their fears. Felt their fists, tasted it in tears. I bent the other in their eyes. I've been the subject of their lies. But it's the hills I've climbed that got me here. Every crumb, every minute, every day. Every precious second, every word we choose to say. I'm gonna live out loud and stand proud till I'm called away. Every crumb, every minute, every day. Look at me, say my name. Your embarrassment's no shame. Of circumstance, this skin, these bones only hold who we are. What you see in the mirror is just an avatar. Who we'll be and what we're worth is no mere accident of birth. We are all the dust of that same sweet distant star. Every crumb, every minute, every day. Every precious second, every word we choose to say. I'm gonna live out loud and stand proud until I'm called away. Every crumb, every minute, every day. I'm gonna live out loud and
That was John McCutcheon. With every crumb,
right,
every minute, every day.
That was stunning. Way to go, Becky. Way to go.
So Josh has a question over here. Let me give the mic to him.
Well, yeah. What is this book about?
It's about my life. Growing up from both of our perspectives. And whenever we read through parts of it, we find humor. We find the humor in unexpected places. But I think that's the way life is.
Well, that's life as an optimist, Becky, which is what you are. You know what, folks? You're tuned to KPFA, if you didn't know, 94.1 FM. And you're listening to Pushing Limits, and that was the voice of Becky Taylor. Dena Taylor, her mom, is here along with us. And I'm Shelley Berman, here with Sheila Gunn-Cushman and Adrian Lobby and Josh Elwood. And we are talking about Becky and Dena's book, Tell Me the Number Before Infinity. You can join Cynthia and Bud and Jean and get yourself a copy of this really glorious book for a $75 pledge when you call 1-800-439-5732. That's 1-800-439-5732. I'm kind of still in tears from John's song, Every Crumb, Every Minute, Every Day, because he said that when you look in the mirror, Becky, that you see an avatar, but you, when you look in the mirror, you see a lot more than that. I wonder if you can talk about that.
Well, the way that I understand that is that our bodies is that everybody's body is an avatar for the person inside.
Right. That's how I read it too.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I remember somewhere in your book towards the end you were saying that every day you go out the door, you look in the mirror and smile at yourself and take that energy out. And that energy is really throughout this book. It is very full of humor and optimism. What can I say?
I want somebody to read the story about the monsters and the cookies.
Okay, I can read that. Do we have time for that?
Oh, yeah. We got time for that because, you know, and you can, we got no callers on the line. We have a $500 matching grant. We haven't received the amount of money we need yet for the matching grant.
We're just about halfway there.
About halfway there. 1-800-439-5732. 1-800-439-5732 or go online at kpfa.org.
Okay. There are monsters biting at my brain, Becky told us. She was 5, maybe 6. They won't go away. At night, in your dreams, I asked. No, in the day. When in the day? Just sometimes in the day. What do they look like? They have teeth all over. Can you tell them to go away? I asked her. I mean, look right at them and yell at them to get out of there. I tried that. I even put up signs in my brain saying, go away, bugger off, close down forever. But it didn't do any good. We were sitting at the kitchen table. Rodney and I looked at each other and burst out laughing. What a kid. Where did she get the idea to do that? Well, that certainly was a good try, I told her. I wondered if there was any connection between biting her brain and the fact that she is brain damaged. Can you draw us a picture of one of the monsters? Rodney asked her. We got her a pencil and paper, and she drew a shape with teeth all over it. She said the monsters were white. I have an idea, Rodney said. Let's make some cookies that look like your monsters. Then, every time they come into your head, you can take a cookie and eat it. Shall we do that? Becky considered this plan and said yes. So Rodney made some cookie dough and cut out monster shapes using Becky's drawing. Then he put cornflakes all over them for the teeth and put them in the oven to bake. When the monster cookies were cool, we put them in a big glass jar on a low shelf so Becky could reach them. A few days later, she took a cookie and ate it. The monsters never came back. we finally threw the moldy cookies out.
Woohoo! I just wish that every kid had that kind of out-of-the-box thinking support.
And well, we were out of the box, that's for sure.
and I know that parents of kids with disabilities are, they come in all shapes and sizes, just as the kids do. But I think that that positive response is so lacking, and that whole acceptance is so lacking. I'm almost going to cry. That, and that difference needs to be accepted and welcomed. And that's the only way we're going to get through these barriers, else they won't move. And I'm so jealous, but I'm so grateful, and I'm so happy that you guys have written this. I think that Adrian's right. I think that everybody in education ought to read it, especially everybody in special education. And I think that the thing that special ed didn't do for me, and the thing that mainstreaming does not do, is help the kids get through the BS that happens. And I think that either the kid gets through it on their own or they don't. And that's not good enough. And I'd like to see better, because I kind of am not as crazy about special ed and mainstreaming as everybody else seems to be, or seems that they were when these laws were passed. They passed the laws, but we're the casualties. And yet, we're the soldiers. So, to everybody, I think we can do this if we just hang on. And KPFA needs to be here in order to deliver that message. We need to be here in order to deliver that message. And to that end, we still are asking for money, because we need it to keep going. Bills never stop, not for households and not for radio stations. www.kpfa.org and 1-800-439-5732. We still have the match on the table. We still have about 25 minutes that we can use to get to our goal. And to say this is an important voice that needs to be here on KPFA, and that Becky's book and things like Becky's book and Dena's should have a place to be showcased, and that people who don't get to be heard should get to be heard. And KPFA plays things that people don't otherwise hear.
I think you came here from Santa Cruz today.
That's right.
That's a long way to come in this kind of inclement weather. Thank you for being here live and in person. And this is what we do here at Pushing Limits. We get folks here in person, live and in person, so that the voices can be heard live and in person. And listening to Becky right here this half hour so far has been inspiring for me, and I hope for you too. Can you let us know by getting on the phone and dialing 1-800-439-5732 and supporting your favorite radio show on your favorite radio station? 1-800-439-5732. $75 pledge will get you a copy of this beautiful book, and it is beautiful and thoughtful and inspiring and optimistic. And what is optimism in this day and age?
It's a precious commodity.
Exactly. It's hard not to be depressed right now. And we are not depressed right here because of folks like Becky and Dena coming in and joining us and sharing this beautiful gift. Tell me the number before infinity.
So I just want to stick up a little bit for those activists who encouraged mainstreaming, because before that, our community was not educated at all. You know, they were stuck in schools and not given the basic education often. So this is a transition. We're hoping it's a better transition to something better. And as hearing Sheila talk about her education, Becky, I saw you nodding and nodding. And I just wondered if you have something you'd like to say to Sheila or to our audience about what that was like for you.
Well, I mean, it certainly was hard being in the first group, and I wish that there'd been more education over surrounding me and surrounding and surrounding all of it. People who are mainstreamed, but I think that that's what shows like Pushing Limits do. I mean, what shows like Pushing Limits does it provides that education.
Well, I wish that all the monsters we had to fight were as imaginary as the ones you had with the cookies. And it, you know,
or could
the
be killed
who,
by eating a cookie. That'd be kind of cool.
The people who are standing in your way in Santa Cruz.
I don't want no orange cookies.
but tell me about your current activism. You know, you're now an activist and you're on this disability commission for a long time now. Who are the monsters there? Who are standing in front of things being progressive and working forward in Santa Cruz? What are you trying to do about it? I thought I'd ask you a really easy question.
Yeah.
Are they monsters or just people that don't know what they're doing?
They're just people who don't know not even what they're doing, but how to they don't know how to do it.
Yeah.
So is your work on the commission mostly education, or are you having to like fight and say, no, this is right. You may think you're right, but I'm right. This is what's really true.
We do stuff like go to meetings and help people help convince people that they need a ramp in a historic building and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm. Wow, it's the hard stuff. It's the in the trenches, this thing, this building, this ramp. Yes.
And I imagine it's programmatic access too. I mean, every day I'm fighting accessibility on the web and in apps and things. The assumption of mouse and monitor are not universal.
Right. No, they're not. I mean, I've had to deal with that assumption for a long time.
Right.
And And not everyone can use a mouse. And
right.
So what's your advice for the disability movement? So let's talk about that. Like, you have obviously a logical brain and a math brain, and then you've had all this training through your school. What is it the disability movement is not clued into?
Well, I think that... I think that, they're not... I think that my advice would be to pick an issue and to get together and work and work for that one issue and then pick another issue.
I've been saying that for years.
Okay.
Yeah, so sort of be more focused.
If every person with a disability picked one issue as the biggest issue that they do, and I bet there'd be a lot of cross things, like I'd pick one and Joe would pick one and George would pick one and George picks the same one I do, we could really get things moving. And it wouldn't be so overwhelming if you didn't think you had to pick every issue but just pick one.
Correct. And also, if you picked one issue, then you could see progress on that one issue.
Yeah, which is really helps with the optimism piece. Yeah.
Well, let me just break in here. This is Shelley, and you're listening to Pushing Limits here on KPFA. And you've been listening to the voice of Becky Taylor, and Dena Taylor is here, too, in studio with us. They've written a book called Tell Me the Number Before Infinity, which we're offering for a $75 pledge to KPFA. And thank you so much, Karen, from Grayton, for calling in and getting the book. I hope you are dry and that you're safe. And Karen says, thank you for this brave, innovative, and relevant radio station. Thank you all. Ooh. Love you all. Peace. And peace be with us all, avatars. Please call us 1-800-439-5732 and let us know that you are listening, that you care enough about KPFA and keeping us free and clear and away from any kind of corporate or political anything, that we are free to have voices of disabled people on the airwaves, on our 50,000 watts that beam out joy to the world, because we are on kpfa.org. If you have access to your computer right now, if you're not sitting in the dark listening, well, it's light out, so sitting in the light, but no, with no lights, listening to your radio station, give us a call, 1-800-439-5732. We have a $500 matching grant given to us from RAIN in Albuquerque, and your dollars will be doubled right now. So please do join us and join the community right here that is, it's loving and gracious and offers hope and inspiration. So, yeah.
We are voices of hope. We are voices of dissent. We are voices of censure. We are voices of pride. We are voices of song. We are voices of magic. We are voices of reason. KPFA aired the Michael Cohen trials. KPFA aired...
And that was stunning, by the way. Thank you, KPFA, for airing Michael Cohen.
And they aired the Kavanaugh hearings, and they've aired many things over the decades, 70 years old old enough to be my, not quite grandpa, old enough to be my dad, anyway.
What makes you think KPFA is a boy?
Well, maybe it's gender non-binary. I don't know.
You know, it is a pleasure to be here today. I mean, driving up from Santa Cruz is nothing really. It's a wonderful program. It's a wonderful station, and we appreciate all the calls, and please give us a call.
1-800-439-5732. 1-800-439-5732. We have two callers on the line. Won't you join those two callers on the line and help us reach our goal of $2,000, Adrian, in our hour?
That's right. And we're up to $300 on that that $500 match. We've got to raise some money here, folks. And Josh is going to help us do it.
Yeah. I laugh, and laughingly, I grew up here for those 70 odd years.
You look really good for 70 odd years old, Josh. I gotta say.
No, but it's true.
You've been around for 30 or 40 years here, is what you're saying.
You're about right, Sheila. But there are a few just KPFA kids that hang out here. I fell in here and was lucky to do so. 848-5732, 1-800-439-5732. Please, y'all, all it takes is you pick up your phone, 1-800-439-5732.
So let us say it slow.
1-800-439-5732.
And I've got to warn you that coming up soon, Josh will be interviewing another one of the KPFA kids who also happens to be disabled. So help us stay on the air just a few more months, and you're going to get to hear that interview.
And in April, we're going to, for Earth Day, interview an environmentalist with autism from Sweden. Right around Earth Day.
Would that be, can you say the name?
That's Greta Thunberg.
We got her.
Yes, we got her.
Well, I need
to talk to her. I haven't.
Oh.
We have a hope. Oh, my goodness. We're putting it out on the air.
We have a hope.
Okay, well, that's why we put out on the air whatever we think. And right now we're thinking that we're going to make this $500 match. We're going to make this $2,000 goal. And we have one caller on the line. So we are, you know, I'm beaming Becky's optimism. That's just where it's at. The number again is 1-800-439-5732. We really need your support here, folks.
Or if you want to go online, it's www.kpfa.org.
I wonder if Becky or Dena would read one more vignette from the book. Pick something that you love.
What do you think, Becky?
She's flipping.
This is radio in action, guys. Got one.
I'm not sure. Maybe it would be best if you read something.
Okay, why don't I read the epilogue? It's quite short.
That's a great idea. We'd all like to know sort of where you are at the moment. Where did you end up here?
Okay. Becky's life has not turned out as I thought it would. I imagined an easier life. This was a girl with an amazing mathematical and logical mind and an indomitable spirit to go with it. As an infant, she lay in bed one night saying, "Grows, dies, grows, dies." "What are you talking about?" we asked. "Life," she answered. As a 7-year-old, she put on Anna's roller skates and told me that she was going to try them out. "Really?" I asked. "Yes. You can either come outside and watch me, or you can stay in here." I thought people, companies, organizations, colleges would want her on their team just to think. But no, she is disabled. She walks and talks funny. This makes people uneasy, and it makes me mad and sad and wondering if there's anything I can do to change this, and then asking myself if I should relax, breathe, and understand that Becky is happy and is changing the world in small, important ways. Becky now lives in a place she loves in downtown Santa Cruz. Mm-hmm. She is near a terrific bookstore, several good restaurants, movie theaters, stores, and a great museum. She does freelance computer work, is active in disability organizations, takes care of her body, and has friends and family who love her. She is fiercely independent and has a wonderful sense of humor. You would be lucky to know her.
We are lucky to know her.
Absolutely. That's what I was about to say, Sheila. Get out of my head.
No, it's warm in here.
We are lucky to know her, and we are so fortunate to be on the air here at KPFA, because there are not places where voices of disability can be here and allowed to thrive on the air here. Thank you from Larkspur. There's a comment. I feel grateful for the station and the genuineness of the programs and the people who share their lives. The strengths and difficulties of their lives make me feel empowered as a human being. Thank you for that call from Larkspur. Yes.
That is our goal, so thank you,
exactly,
Larkspur.
Exactly. That's why we're here. Please join Larkspur. 1-800-439-5732. We did make our match, and now we're shooting for $2,000. We've got 4 minutes to raise.
Yeah, nothing.
900.
We could do it.
Well, you know, it could happen. 1-800-439-5732. You know, thank you for sharing your inspiration here on our airwaves. I feel so fortunate to be here, and I feel fortunate that we have the opportunity to share voices like this on the air.
So, Becky, one last word. What would you like to leave our listeners with?
That we are so fortunate to be... that all of us are so fortunate to have KPFA.
Wow, that's unsolicited. You know, when people get on the microphone, they don't usually say something nice about you. They usually use it to say their own thoughts.
Raw and real, ladies and gentlemen.
Any final thoughts there, Dena Taylor?
Again, it's been a pleasure being here with you. I'm inspired by this show. I think it's so important. The radio station KPFA is so important. So amazing that it's been here for 70 years.
Shout out for Women's Day coming up. There's going to be some disability stuff in that too. So it's March 9th, a Saturday, from 6 a.m. to midnight. A whole lot of programming about women.
And there is still time to get this wonderful book for a $75 pledge. Tell me the number before infinity. I am looking for that number, and so read the book and give me some help. 1-800-439-5732. You won't regret it. It is really a terrific book.
And a great big thank you to Becky Taylor and Dena Taylor for coming in today and sharing. And to Josh Elwood, Adrian Lobby, and Sheila Gunn Cushman. Thank everybody who called. Thank you very much, listeners. Keep calling 1-800-439-5732. Bless you all.
Let's not forget our engineer, Mike Kahn. Thank you so much.
Thanks. Have a good weekend, everybody.
Keep all the pressure. Keep all the pressure. I've got to keep on pushing. I can't stop now. Move up a little higher. Some way or somehow. 'Cause I've got my strength. And it don't make sense.
You're listening to 94.1 KPFA, 89.3 KPFB in Berkeley, 88.1 KFCF in Fresno, and 97.5 K248BR in Santa Cruz. Thank you for pushing limits from Lori and Phil in San Rafael.